welcome to race day. And before we get down to it, last minute checks are being made.
We've seen some unbelievable action around the Autodromo Hermanos Rodriguez in the past. Ferrari's Sebastian Vettel had to fight off both Red Bull drivers, only to be demoted off the podium in 2016 in what was a highly controversial moment. And the weather today is sunny. These are ideal conditions for the drivers to shine.
Well, we're expecting some dizzying strategies used here today, here in the Mexican Heights. The question is, though, who's going to be the one to climb to the top?
Hopefully, Mercedes. That's significantly faster. Like 25 and 26 lap stints. Almost completely identical. Yeah, no rain expected. We'll just we'll go from here.
We're nearly ready to get started here. 71 laps, 17 turns. It's the Mexico City Grand Prix. The anticipation and excitement may be building up, but there's a cool head on Carlos Sainz.
They sit in 17th, and let's be honest, no one wants to be at the back of the pack. But can they?
Certainly not. Here?
But there's no more time left. We've got a race on our hands.
It's race time.
What will happen next?
Hey, Blitzby, how you doing, sir?
The Mexico City Grand Prix. It's lights out, and away we go.
Show me what you've got.
Okay, Montoya. Okay, Montoya, calm.
Overtake is available.
Copy.
Russell's kind of been the tough one here. Last couple of races. My biggest barrier to winning. Basically, we're just trying not to lose positions. Just prevent overheating here.
Just take care of the tires for the moment.
Copy.
Couple of seconds there.
So we DRS this lap.
Russell's fastest lap.
Currently, P2.
We've got a yellow flag here.
Leclerc spun. Let's see from what position. 12. That helps Stroll's race. We don't really like that. Kind of burning it now. We don't really need to be pushing, so. The AI are like using all their energy in that. Trying to burst out of Russell isn't the plan either, because our tire is just going to get harder to work with as it goes on. We only have 3/10 and that's going to evaporate pretty quickly. Is gonna go hard early. We just let them and see where we shake out in the grand scheme of everything.
Oh my goodness.
Good job.
I'll try taking care of our tires and seeing where we kind of land. So far, Montoya's just going backwards. A little push, see what we can do. I'm trying to stretch Russell if I can. At least early. I'm gonna kind of be a sitting duck here.
Charge the pack.
God, why are you trying to overtake on the back straight? Like, you're just not going to get anywhere. Now we're actually vulnerable to third, which is a bit of a problem. We need to burn some juice to stay ahead of Norris. Let's do a deliberate slowdown.
Just to reduce your speed.
Copy. Start reducing that management.
Yeah, copy.
Yeah, it's kind of going all out. Russell's not being kind to the tires. That is not difficult to see at all. Driver view? This is probably the closest thing. This, like, last one. Montoya's POV. It gets kind of, like, there's a lot of, like, motion. Which is one of the reasons I kind of try to avoid it. I mean, it's there. You can use it. That's all I'm trying to say.
And we need to increase pushing status.
Copy, copy.
Yeah, we're down 0.2 already. And now we're like 10 laps in, which is where our tires are supposed to overlap, so I think the goal is just to kind of stay with Russell. Yeah, it wasn't possible in 22, but they did add this angle specifically for 2023. Let's take our aggression off.
Look after the front tires.
Copy, copy.
Looks like we'll hold 7th for the time being. Lawson's just not on pace. Yeah, my plan is lap 20. And hopefully Russell will be undercuttable.
So increase pushing status.
I'm just going to throw Montoya's pace and tires off a little bit more because he's in a completely different race back here. I do like the overhead view, the motion's a little bit easier to stomach. What I'm really hoping is that we can just kind of hold Russell and break away from Norris. Norris has form all of a sudden. Yeah, these guys all know that you need to stay in DRS, so... it's kind of where we're at.
Push for these laps, you're doing a good job.
Okay. Norris is kind of on the precipice now. If we could lose him, that would be a lot less pressure on me. He should be outside of the detection zone. Which will be very helpful on us just pulling away.
And we need to take care of these tires.
Copy.
Yeah, this is going to be a bit of a losing battle. But this is where preserving the softs will pay off. Because while the pace of the AI falls apart on them, we can hopefully keep up with the medium runner Russell. There's a crash. Big crash.
There's been a crash.
Boom. Ah, that's nothing. That's a fender bender. Yeah, these tires just rapidly lose pace, so we just have to be very, very careful. we're going to eventually lose this position, I think. Main problem is just that the grip just isn't going to be there. I already had a bit of a grip deficit. Did we get to measure? Oh, that's 4/10. And that's a lot more. We're just taking care of our tires and just trying to stay with Russell. We're not looking to be aggressive at this point. Mick. Yeah, they should go down another tier in tire grip, which should help our cause. Take care of their tires.
It's not gonna be long now, mate.
I think we do want to try to break away. Not from Russell, but from the other cars.
Push and hold, overtake.
Copy.
From Norris, Mick, those guys. It might be futile. We'll see.
No lift off needed. You are doing a good job.
Copy. Yeah, we're just kind of going for broke now. Spread of 1.5 seconds. We did lose the position to Lawson, which... not gonna worry too much about at this point. Set up our box now.
So deployed, deployed.
Norris and Mick both pit this lap, which is early. Now things are going to get a bit critical. Norris and Mick both took new softs. Which is a strategy I don't think is going to work.
If we could just drop back a bit.
Copy.
Yeah, let's go. Slow pit stop. Not that slow.
Track will be clear.
Start pushing them.
Copy.
We're directly behind Norris at the moment. Which, cold tires, that's fine. It's gonna happen. I am curious about the end game that they're planning.
An increase lift and coast.
Okay, copy.
Just reduce your speed.
Copy.
And we need to look after these tires.
Copy.
Given the way the AI consumes tires, I don't want to push. Not pushing is like just the absolute right way to go. These tires are about 5 tenths down when they start hitting the low 70s. I gotta wait for me to get down to about 80%. Sonoda pits. Lawson. Not particularly concerned about Norris's overall pace. I would really love for some of these drivers to pull into the pits now. These guys staying out is going to become a bit of an issue.
show me what you've got.
Yeah, copy.
Yeah, it's a little late now. These guys staying out is just going to be a pain. Bunch of pit stops. What?
Look at the Mercedes. Oh, and a fairly substantial crash there.
No. That is absolute death. We now need to take a gearbox penalty. That is a championship altering crash. Potentially. Hold on, can we get to the end on the hards? Pause. Yeah, we have to try.
I'm coming in the pit lane now.
Yeah, Aether. Just keep an eye on your mirrors.
I didn't change the pit stop. I changed the strategy, but I didn't change the pit stop. What a disaster. It's an absolute fucking disaster. You've got to be kidding me.
We should slow down.
Push and hold it, overtake.
Thank you. Just in a matter of seconds, like, the whole thing is just gone. I'm now tasked with having to be Ocon with Montoya. Well, Stroll actually is in 10th, so that part is accurate.
And we'll need liftoff.
We have to make a third stop with Maloney, though. I think that's hurt our race pretty badly.
And tires are good to push.
Copy, copy.
Oh, we don't have DRS because it's broken. Of course.
And charge button on. Charge button on.
Copy, copy.
That is so bad. Just an unforced error from Maloney. And it's significant. It's absolutely significant. It matters. This is the last thing we fucking needed.
Charge on.
Copy, copy.
We're screwed with Maloney. And now we have to take a gearbox penalty. That's even worse. There is a retire car option somewhere. Yeah, here it is. We're just going to retire him. There's
box.
Absolutely no reason to go on.
Is he there?
Copy.
Damage mitigation is down to Montoya now. He easily had a race win, too. That's why it's frustrating. He's sitting there dueling with the car he doesn't need to duel with. Not a faster tire. And you just can't keep your composure. Like, what the heck? You know?
Charge button on.
Copy.
Russell's gonna win, and easily. This is a really bad time for Maloney to crash the car.
Charge button on. Charge button on.
Okay.
I've got the overtake aggression.
Charge button on.
Copy.
See if we can weave him into these cars at all.
No lead off needed. You are doing a good job.
Copy.
Mine Toya just doesn't, like, have the race pace. Main thing with Maloney, I was feeling, is to just preserve the components that are left and are remaining in the car.
To take care of these tires. And we need to increase lift and coast.
Fuck!
Alright, let's concentrate.
Yeah, they're just... This is infuriating. Like, the way they push is kind of opposite to the way we push, so we can just be vulnerable to this. Dragovic is preserving. He has to be, because we're just... Because his tires were about the same. He's with us, and he's not really... using his tires. Verstappen is cogging us, which is bad. Because it's going to destroy our hope of catching Ocon. Basically, have to out-execute the AI on pit stops.
Copy.
Why do we keep losing ground? To give the whole dang thing up.
And we need you to take care of the tires.
Copy.
I hate how they use a DRS as a protective cloak.
Do we need to save tires in high speed?
Copy.
Verstappen just beat it now.
Gotta go now. We've gotta get into the DRS range.
So deployed. Take care of the tires.
Yeah, we're going in.
And box this black box.
It's all down to Montoya to like pull this off now. Where did Norris... Okay.
I'm going into pit lane now.
And copy that.
We have to beat Ocon. Nothing else really matters. Oh, come on!
No traffic in pit exit.
The game actively works against you. It's like, what the heck? I'll be right back. Yeah, I land their training load specifically so I wouldn't have pit stop mistakes, and I have pit stop mistakes. It's infuriating.
Look after the tires, please.
Now I'm behind Lance Stroll. Lovely. I'm gonna go get water. I'll be right back.
On the main straight. Virtual safety car deployed. Stay as close as possible to the Delta.
Copy.
That is gonna hurt us.
The tires in high speed. Try to look after the tires.
The issue isn't that they should never happen. The issue is that this game has literally just stacked the deck against me by, like, having that mistake happen in that moment. Cause it's, they basically just took 4 seconds of race time and took it away from me. Just snatched it, like, out of my hands. In a situation where I really need to be damage mitigating.
Safety car ending.
And they've literally taken my ability away to damage mitigate, because now I'm probably going to lose the Lance Stroll too. Because they gave, like, the AI free pit stops, they gave Stroll fresher tires, and they took 4 seconds from me. On a strategy execution where I was supposed to end up way ahead. Because I've undercut Ocon. I'm undercutting Ocon. But I think it's just an issue I have with this game at large, where pit stop mistakes are just far too likely to happen for my liking.
Thank you.
Like, this whole race is like bull and bull hockey. Yeah, Ocon got a free pit stop, so he gets to win now. Having to work against this much when you're in a close championship fight is just frustrating. They handed a race win to Ocon in a situation where he was in a bad pit stop situation too. Basically, just on the premise that he just didn't stop. He gets rewarded. I'm just beyond angry at this one. This is ridiculous. Is Mercedes expects like a constructor's win, so do I get fired now if I fail to achieve it? Stroll shouldn't be anywhere near me either. This part is just like anger inducing. But the thing I'm most angry about is the fact that Ocon's gonna win when he shouldn't have been anywhere near victory. Like, absolutely nowhere near it.
And we need to look after these tires.
The real issue is my friend, who wanted Montoya on this team. I think that is the single biggest decision that made us most vulnerable. Not because it's not a bad long-term move, but because Montoya just, with the starting skill set he was at, is just a drag on this team. He probably won't be next season, but this season he definitely has been. Next season he's going to start probably about as good as Sargeant did. And he's more solid, so there's that too. But the frustrating thing about this is getting screwed out of damage mitigation when I have to take an engine penalty, a gearbox penalty. I now have to take one, probably. Because I don't think these gearbox, like 66% or whatever, is going to make it. And in general, I don't run components yellow in races. I mean, it is the single biggest contrast in points production here. Because last season, Maloney and Sargent were fighting for the driver's title. That's like 200 points deficit. The strength to bury Red Bull in this race, but goddamn, like, this is infuriating. And I really don't want things to come down to us needing, like, to perform, like, well enough at the very end, because stuff like this can happen. Jack 2, thank you for the follow, sir. It would be a lot less frustrating if Montoya was simply better at driving, which isn't happening yet. Come on. We can't afford to fall out of DRS. It's not looking good for us even finishing in the points. I really needed those 4 seconds.
Take care of the tires.
These guys wouldn't even been a threat without the VSC either.
So we need to push.
Like, that's how much the game screwed me over on this race. Thing I really want to see him get rid of is a lot of the random spins. Like, you get those sometimes in the races from the bottom teams, but, like, the bigger boys don't. It just doesn't happen. Tsunoda's on mediums. Can't leave that door open. You just cannot leave that door open, man.
And take care of the tires.
Copy.
I was gonna lose my sanity at the end of this, I think.
You can push.
Get out of town. I get screwed over on the DRS distribution.
Keep doing it like this.
Part of this is bad, it's just the way that the drivers just have no awareness on the DRS line. How my driver just manages to like be that unaware. To be like left without DRS on the big straight.
Just take care of the
just bad like racecraft. As a racing fan, I kind of want DRS to go away. Because I think more what ends up happening with it is it keeps slower cars in races. Where they really shouldn't be in the race. Races like this where my driver just lose control by being stuck behind a car that has to get by you. Main thing is just that this shouldn't even be happening.
And charge button on.
Like these drivers were like 10-15 seconds back without this VSC.
And charge button on when you.
And that's really just inexcusable.
Sorry.
deployed. Deployed. Copy, copy.
Magnussen has a well, now he doesn't. He's used a lot of tire just like trying to surge.
No lift off needed. You are doing a good job. Charge on. Gear TRS. Charge button on and charge button off. Charge button off.
Big group of cars with way worse tires than us. I'll be right back.
And try to keep it smooth. So there was a crash, and was debris around the track.
I did not happen to see who we lost.
Charge button on.
Will be charge button off.
At first it sounded like it was actually my car.
The
hell?
So virtual safety car deployed. Virtual safety car deployed.
Stay positive.
Yeah, copy, copy.
I don't know.
So there was a crash.
Watch for debris in front.
This can go on for a little bit.
Virtual safety car ending.
Copy, copy.
And DRS enabled.
I don't think we're gonna get it because we're not over the detection point.
Thank you. charge button off.
We could get fifth. Probably have to start stepping on it.
Energies are good. And charge button on. Charge button on.
Magnuson is trying to stay, but he doesn't exactly have the grip. Probably sixth is where I'm gonna like settle. Be right back. Just emptying the battery. The wrong driver's in front now. Ocon does win, which...
Ocon first over the line today.
That's why Maloney needed to be there. That is just... Oh, it makes me want to, like, break something.
And check a flag. And P7 at the end.
Thank you. It's not so much that he crashed, it's the fact that he had damaged the gearbox that's irking me the most. Like, frankly, everything depended on that gearbox being intact.
What an excellent result today for the Mercedes driver.
It's safe to say they exceeded all expectations. A finish in the points, and my goodness, it is very well deserved.
It's hugs all round for the team. In fact, they all deserve a pat on the back as well for everything that they've achieved. And as proceedings start to wind down here, what will Mercedes have made of this result, Karun?
It was a strangely mixed weekend for them. We saw one driver put in a strong performance, but it was a different story for the other. Definitely positives there.
Unforced crashing error.
And that's it from us all here in Mexico City.
Coming up in the next round is the Sao Paulo Grand Prix as we head to
Brazil.
Join us next time at Interlagos.
Which I think I have time to do today, actually. Yeah, we're down 6. We need to cancel that and immediately start manufacturing new underfloors. Rush it. Eight days. Okay. Manufacturing, we need to manufacture an extra one. What do we have for chassis? Yeah, we gotta go to 2. That's gonna hurt too. Suspensions we need. Yeah, that's gonna... Okay. Do we get an underfloor? care.